to go over how to set up your platform for the flat banded deadlifts. So there are two different ways to do this, and it's just going to depend on how much resistance you need and want. So I like to start with my carabiners on either side of the band, and we're either going to do just one half of the band underneath or both under the platform. So I found it easiest to lean this bad boy against my knees. And if I'm just gonna do one band, I'm gonna lay it down and make sure it's flat underneath the platform in that area where there's no rubber. And I'm gonna place it down, and I'm gonna take a minute to kind of make sure it's nice and even. And then if you wanted to do it this way, you're going to clip your flat band into it here, so it would look like this. I'm not going to, because I'm gonna show you how to do the full band. So other option would then be to have the full band underneath the platform. So you wanna make sure it's as flat as possible, as even as possible. And then we're gonna place the platform down. We're going to clip in to our bar. And then we are all set up for your deadlift. And let's go over how to do a traditional deadlift. So first and foremost, I like to go back to thinking about our squat that, let me just rally up over here. So the squat that we've worked on, deadlifts really aren't a whole lot different as far as the base position as a squat is. So you're gonna be in your squat position, you're gonna grab a hold of your bar, and we're gonna think about dropping your booty low. And with a deadlift, we're going to make sure our body moves in one solid motion. So we're going to stand up and allow our arms to pull at the same time. So we're one nice fluid motion. That's usually what happens is booty comes up, and then we turn this into like a dual motion movement where we want to feel nice and fluid, keeping our upper back engaged the whole time as we stand up and come back down. So I'll do a couple of those on the platform so you can see.